welcome back to Andresa Ray, where today we'll be watching The Haunting of Bly Manor. I have been looking forward to this show since the trailers came out, since The Haunting the Hill of whatever that other show was called. That season ended, I was like, I want more of this. So I've been looking forward to this show for a while. I don't have much to say because I don't really know much about it. I did hear that it's a new cast. It deals with another haunting of a house, obviously, the haunting of Bly Manor. And we're just gonna get a little more scare. Now the last, I guess it was a season, these have nothing to do with each other. The Haunting of the Hill House, I think it was called, has nothing to do with The Haunting of Bly Manor. But that season of The Haunting of the Hill House was a really good. It tied everything up. You were always wondering, guessing, and trying to figure things out. So I'm hoping that this show is just like that. And I have high hopes. So I'm ready to jump into this and see what this haunting has got to give. Bloop.
We lay, my love and I, beneath the weeping willow.
Oh God, already creepy.
But now, alone I lie.
Northern California, 2007.
Did you know that almost half of marriages these days do not end up in divorce?
That means there's a strong probability that you two get to watch each other die.
It's all. And if that scares you as much as it scares me, then I say run.
Go off and do drugs on a beach in Bali. Devote yourself to a life of the mind. Run!
Again, this story isn't mine, but it is full of ghosts of all sorts. A great good place. Alone in the country.
Well, it's a whole different thing here.
Yes, it is. You've no previous experience as an au pair. Exceptional, really, my niece and my nephew. Exceptional children, as I said. But challenging, both. There is a live-in housekeeper, but the children would be your responsibility and yours alone. Don't call on me, unless it's an emergency. I'm extraordinarily busy. I wonder, what's the catch? You're younger than most who'd apply for this sort of thing. What makes a woman of your age want to give up her life to take care of someone else's children?
Seems to me an easy position to fill. At least as you've described. So I suppose you're right. What is the catch?
Yeah.
That really is the question.
I like her.
No one wants the job.
Oh, come on. No one.
We did find someone for a while last summer. Well, I suppose she died. It was her own fault, to be blunt. Her choice. Never mind that parents died abroad, never mind the governess took her own. So yes, the story precedes the job, at least at all the agencies now.
Biad said two children. I figure I don't know the specifics, but I know how to handle kids. Maybe I can make a difference. I noticed the position was full time, live in, and then it clicked. They've lost someone. But it could go on for quite a... No, I know. I know it's longer than I said, but I got a job. Anyway. You can reach me when I get to the house.
Why does she want...
I'll call you when I have the number.
I was born in Bly. The town, I mean, not the manor. I escaped for a bit. Spent some time in France.
What?
Studying to be a chef. I've actually never liked Bly. The people here, most of them, they're born here, they die here. Whole town's one big gravity well.
What a beautiful song!
What song?
The one you were just saying?
You're Miss Clayton. You must be.
Now, what's that?
Oh, this. Just a silly thing, really. Just a moment. And do you know there are leeches in there? Whole little things like vampire slugs. And the nastiest beetles. Who needs that old palette anyway? There's so much else that's so much better than I imagined.
This is her. Hi, Miles. So pleased to meet you, my lady.
This is so grown.
What a gentleman. And this must be Mrs. Gross. Hi.
I'm sorry. Goodness, I was miles away. Children, you're calling Miss Clayton like we agreed.
Her first look at Bly yielded no discomfort.
It was so nice.
Foreboding. It was exactly as Lord Wingrave had described.
This is a foyer. And it's perfectly splendid.
It's beautiful.
Come along. Lovely stairs. But you mustn't run on them. If you fall, you can injure yourself. And this is where our parents used to live.
Miles gave it to me. Why not?
Because it doesn't belong to you.
Oh, God, she just turned.
Miss Jessel.
Who's that?
The other one. Before you.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
What is that?
You know, Mrs. Gross seems to think you should call me Miss Clayton.
Didn't you like it?
I'm sorry?
The butterfly.
Oh, I...
Look, you can see...
Flora is a little upset, I think. Is that me?
Why, no, silly. You're you. It's just a dolly.
Touché.
Put her back. She stays there. But you have to promise me something.
Of course.
You have to promise me that you'll stay in your room. Don't leave your room at night.
Okay. At least for tonight. Now get some sleep.
To be explored.
Oh gosh, you don't listen. Somebody told me to stay in their bed at night. I'm listening. Oh God, girl. They didn't even put like night lights in the hallway. Candles. Oh God. Is there somebody right over there? Oh my God. Honey, I feel like I am Inspector Gadget. Look at me. I think. Oh my God. Honey, I knew it was somebody.
Let me see what I found.
You left your room last night, even though you promised you wouldn't.
Miss Clayton!
How do you know that?
You've got to stay in your room.
Come and see.
The lady.
What lady?
The lady in the lake.
Flora. In all that time, a lot of kids have tried to scare me in a lot of different ways. And you know what I learned? I'm a lot braver than people think.
Did he ask about us?
Oh. All he did was talk about you two. He misses you both.
The gardener did not even introduce herself to the new au pair. She barely acknowledged her at all. Simply treated her as if she'd always been there.
Was there somebody working on the grounds today? Maybe a repairman or something?
No, I don't believe so.
Because I saw a guy on the parapet on my way in.
A guy?
On the parapet.
They take liberties, but if 1 minute onto the parapet...
Oh, I can get up there anyway, not without going through the house.
Well, the only way up there is through the old wing. Mm. And where don't we go?
The old wing.
Oh, you must have imagined it, dear.
Well, you're not going to eat anything?
Oh, no, I already ate. Just here for the company.
You must try this.
Flora, don't.
Is she going into the dead parents' room? She sure is. Girl. This is your second day slash night, and you are just crossing. Oh, she ain't listening. She's just doing what she wants to do. Godspeed. The testicular fortitude to go there. Look, there's another doll.
but I did find some... I'm sorry, am I interrupting you?
Oh, no, no, not at all. What did you find? There was a man. Which really is the only thing that can bring down a woman like that. All the world's vice is in disguise of its graces. To hear her tell it, Rebecca's body in that water, face down, and little Flora just stone still. It's a tiny game of Flora's to keep us all safe. Both of them trying in their own way, I think.
Imagination. I love your imagination. And everyone in this house is so lucky that you're using yours to keep us safe. And no going on the parapet. Okay?
You really are, you know.
I'm what?
Perfectly splendid.
There's an electric fan in Flora's cupboard. I cannot sleep without it, I'm afraid.
That's why, in my cupboard.
Look at them. Oh, that was it. That was creepy, guys. I'm not gonna lie. I was creepified. Is that a word? It is today. So that was a really good episode. Now we understand the two kids. They're creeps. I think they locked her in that room on purpose for a reason. Either they were gonna visit a ghost, maybe their mom or father, have a conversation with them, say, don't kill this girl yet. Like, she just got here. But she's trying it. So she seems like she's running away from her own demons, and she has like a ghost in a mirror. We got that situation. Then we have this lady who I guess is, I don't know what she is, the black lady. I don't know what her sole purpose is in the house. What is she doing? Because we have a cook, we have a gardener, and then we have her. And all I know is that she prays the candles, and that's it. She knows the kids prior. The mother and father are dead. The girl child, I missed her name. Their English accents are really strong, so some words I'm like, what are you saying? She has a fascination with dolls, or she makes dolls. She has dolls all over the house. There's dolls outside, there's dolls inside, there's dolls in cabins and drawers and places of the house that you shouldn't be in. There's dolls everywhere. Dolls underneath stuff. So clearly the house is possessed. She said she doesn't want... She told the girl not to leave her room because the lady at the lake can't see her. So clearly the lady at the lake is like going to be either the previous nanny who's now like crazy or somebody else that drove that old nanny crazy. There's a lot to tie in here. It was a really good episode, and I cannot wait until next week to watch it again. Well, that was my reaction to The Haunting of Bly Manor. If you are not subscribed, hit that subscribe button. It's either here, 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 or here. And hit that bell notification. It will let you know when I upload all my new content. I will see you all next time on Andres Re. Did that sound good?